Please welcome Félix Maradiaga, Nicaraguan opposition leader.
Es un honor estar ante algunas de las voces
It is an honor for me to speak before you, some of the most qualified voices
humanos.
At a global level to talk about human rights. I am pleased that the organizers of the Geneva Summit have decided to join together inseparably the issues of human rights and democracy.
En el mundo contemporáneo,
in our contemporary world,
oportunistas
there are opportunistic interests that would strive to separate
si
these two concepts,
posible.
As if that were
Una
possible.
De la
A lesson learned from the Nicaraguan
es que
Odyssey
la
is that the apparent stability that many authoritarian regimes claim to ensure
solo una hay
is merely an illusion when it is not accompanied by freedom. Sooner or later, that illusion shatters like a mirror whose fragments scatter violently, hurting the innocent. Peace without freedom is the peace of the grave. So it was that in April 2018, Daniel Ortega's regime, which but a few months before was heralded as the economic miracle of Central America, thanks to the government's strong alliance with the main economic groups in the country, turned into a monster. It attacked protesting citizens with the greatest violence ever seen against the civil population in the history of Nicaragua. In times of peace. As you are an audience that is highly specialized in human rights, you know the facts well, and I will not dwell on details. However, the truth is that no report can accurately describe the terror of seeing snipers of the National Police firing at unarmed civilians who, in the worst case, were trying to defend themselves with slingshots and stones. When facing a uniformed paramilitary army that in less than 90 days killed more than 350 civilians, we estimate that to date the death toll may have reached as many as 500. This was the case of the child Álvaro Conrado, who was shot in the neck while the students protesting in Managua were carrying water on April 20th. When he shouted, "It hurts me to breathe," his companions tried to save his life. But the Ortega regime had already ordered that the wounded protesters were not to receive care in public hospitals. Franco Valdivia, another university student, a singer, a father of a baby girl, was killed with a high-precision shot in his eye. In one of his songs, he says, "I want death to return to me what life has taken from me." Since Daniela Ortega has come into power, the right to free elections has been taken away. Despite all efforts to sound the alarm, the world fell silent. The Ortega regime carried out dozens of extrajudicial killings against farmers in the mountains of Nicaragua since 2007, yet announced that Nicaragua is the safest country in Central America. Opposition political parties were outlawed. In February 2016, the UNDP mission in Nicaragua was even expelled from the country. But still, the world remained silent. The voices of indigenous peoples and peasants for years have asked the world for help in the face of the loss of their property rights due to the expansion of open-pit mining, the degradation of natural reserves, or projects such as the supposed interoceanic canal that a group from China wants to build. Yet all those voices before April seemed too faint and too far away for many. But in April, everything changed. But it is tragic that hundreds of young people like Franco and Alvarito had to die in order to capture the attention of the world. Therefore, today, I come before you with a great weight in my heart, feeling a sacred respect for that bloodshed, in order to ask, do not leave us alone. Help us in our determination to build peace with freedom.
Esa paz solo es posible con el derecho a la memoria,
a la verdad, with the right to recover memory,
a la justicia.
Truth.
Este clamor es especialmente importante en el momento en que el régimen de Ortega, ante el temor a severas sanciones internacionales, ha decidido negociar. Mientras elevo este clamor, en poco más de 10 meses han salido de mi país más de 82,000 nicaragüenses exiliados. La mayoría de ellos por persecución política. Además, han pasado por las cárceles más de 2,000 presos políticos, de los cuales aún están en condición de arresto arbitrario. Más de 650 personas aún permanecen en las cárceles de Nicaragua, activistas de la democracia, como son, por ejemplo, Victoria Obando, Cristian Fajardo, su esposa María Dilia, mi amigo Medardo, Pedro
Amaya,
Irlanda
Nardo,
Edwin,
Brack,
John Amort,
Byron,
Kenia, los periodistas Lucía y Miguel y cientos de personas más.
And hundreds of other people.
Confieso que nadie está preparado emocionalmente para poder tomar el testimonio de muchos de los ciudadanos que han sido apresados y torturados por el régimen sin que esa experiencia nos marque de por vida. Tampoco es posible salir con el alma ilesa después de ver con nuestros propios ojos el cuerpo de jóvenes mutilados por la tortura o ver tanta carne rota por las balas disparadas por la tiranía. Precisamente esta madrugada hablé con alguien a quien llamaré Esperanza para proteger su identidad. Ella logró escapar del secuestro de agentes del Frente Sandinista luego de ser violada múltiples veces en la ciudad de León. Y estas fueron sus palabras. Me secuestraron después de participar en las protestas. Durante días me hicieron sentir dolores más fuertes que un parto. Me lanzaron al lado de la carretera pensando que habían asesinado mi alma. No sabían que más bien habían lanzado una semilla. Esas fueron sus palabras. Esa semilla de esperanza de víctimas como ella es nuestra convicción de que es posible salir de la tiranía a través de la resistencia civil y la no violencia. Esa es la esperanza que nace de acciones como la resolución recién aprobada por el Consejo de Derechos Humanos de la ONU. Sin embargo, para que esa semilla sea un fruto de libertad, es urgente que sea irrigada con la acción internacional que impida que los crímenes de lesa humanidad
that prevents crimes against humanity from being forgotten.
Así como no hay futuro sin
just
memoria,
as there is no future
no es posible
without
cultivar
memory,
la libertad
it is not possible
sin
to
la
cultivate freedom
que solo
without
emana
the light
de la justicia.
That can only emanate
gracias
from justice. Thank you.